Welcome back to Crypto Zeus. The crypto journey continues. In this video, I've got a friend behind me, and that friend represents the dark side of cryptocurrency. So you guys might know him as Darth Vader, but something big has happened today, something big and scary, and that is the biggest hack of a DeFi platform that we've seen in history. So $600 million has vanished. It has been taken away. It has been robbed. And, you know, it's just a reminder that in the crypto space, you are going to run across characters like my friend behind me who can potentially do bad things. So in this video, we're going to go through this hack, kind of what it's all about, and then we're going to try and take some lessons out of this for cyber security, crypto security. What can you do? Is there anything you can do about this? And we'll talk through it. So guys, what happened? Cross-chain DeFi site Poly networked hacked. Hundreds of millions potentially lost. So $600 million plus in crypto has potentially be taken away by our friend right here. And as you can see from the official Poly Network Twitter account behind me, it says, "Important notice, we are sorry to announce that Poly Network was attacked on the Binance Smart Chain and Ethereum, and Polygon assets had been transferred to hackers' following address. And they've left the addresses of the Ethereum and the Binance Smart Chain below." So this is really, really big. And what is the Poly Network? So what is this all about? And I've got the website behind me, and it says, "Realizing blockchain interoperability, building the next generation internet." So this one operates across a lot of different cryptocurrency networks. So it says right here, "The Poly Network is built to implement interoperability between multiple chains in order to build the next generation infrastructure. Authorized, homogeneous, and heterogeneous public blockchains can connect to Poly Network through an open, transparent admission mechanism and communicate with other blockchains. Poly Network has already integrated Bitcoin, Ethereum, NEO, Ontology, Elrond, Zilliqa, Binance Smart Chain, Switch.io, and Huobi ECO chain. More institutions and organizations are welcome to join the Poly Network." So really, it's about bridging. It's about kind of going across all the different blockchains and smart chains and, you know, setting itself up to be kind of, you know, across all these different platforms. And it says here, "What caused the hack or the exploit?" And what caused the exploit? And Poly Network here has said, "After preliminary investigation, we located the cause of the vulnerability. The hacker exploited a vulnerability between contract calls. Exploit was not caused by single keeper as rumored." So that is what they're saying. And another cybersecurity team called Slowmist have kind of detailed the root cause of this hack. And they're saying here in a bit of a summary, you know, it sounds quite complicated. So basically, what are they saying? They're saying that within the contract here, there's a bunch of functions and operations that the exploiter, the hacker, could call upon to basically, down the bottom, they sum it up. "After replacing the address of the keeper role, the attacker can construct a transaction at will and withdraw any amount of funds from the contract." So this is where, you know, Slowmist is saying it happened, and this is the root cause of the Poly Network. So the next question is, you know, what's happened to the funds? Where are the funds right now? And, you know, you can see these public Ethereum addresses. So these addresses are public addresses, and I'm going to bring them up, and this story gets even more interesting. So the bandit, the hacker, has now got the money, and it's sitting in this Ethereum address over here on Etherscan. And you can see it below, and they flagged it. "This address is reported to be involved in a Poly Network exploit." And you can kind of see some of the values right here. So you have 28,000 Ethereum balance, which is absolutely crazy, and huge sums of value right here. And it even gets more interesting because a lot of people are commenting, and you can comment on the Etherscan, and they're commenting right here, potentially are asking for money and ways to even exploit or get the funds out. So right now, the authorities are onto this. So there's a lot of authorities around the world looking at this exploit because of the serious amount of money that's been involved in this, you know, $600 million plus worth of cryptocurrency. And this guy here is saying to send it to Tornado and, you know, get the money out that way. And they see the hackers, you know, Darth Vader, he's getting his little friend bannets to, you know, try and get this money out. And, you know, what is Tornado? And Tornado's another thing. And this is kind of the crypto world. I've got the website behind me, Tornado Cash, a fully decentralized protocol for private transactions on Ethereum. So what is the purpose of this one? It's really, it's trying to achieve privacy, right? So Tornado Cash improves transaction privacy by breaking the on-chain link between the source and destination addresses. It uses a smart contract that accepts Ethereum deposits that can be withdrawn by a different address. To preserve privacy, a relay out can be used to withdraw to an address with no Ethereum balance. Whenever Ethereum is withdrawn by the new address, there is no way to link the withdrawal to the deposit, ensuring complete privacy. So these bandits, you know, you've got Darth Vader here, and you have some young guy right here who is trying to help Darth Vader get the funds out of this wallet and to secretly, you know, send them elsewhere without the authorities knowing. But this is kind of the dark side of cryptocurrency. This is the underbelly of cryptocurrency. And you know, what's even interesting about reading through some of these comments, and you guys know along the Crypto Zeus journey, there are hackers and bandits everywhere. And this person here, it's me, has dropped a comment, and he's trying to scam people who are interested in getting money off the hacker. And this hacker is, this person here is saying, send an ETH amount and get 30 times back, ETH back only one transaction per address. And he's saying that's an update from the hacker, and the ETH address is this one right here. And guys, I can tell you, that is not a hacker update. That's it's me right here trying to get free Ethereum. So this guy is just trying to get people to send him free Ethereum. So you always have to remember, in the crypto world, there are little bandits everywhere. You have big bandits who steal $600 million worth of crypto, and then you're gonna have these little bandits as well, you know, trying to help out the big bandits up the top here. This guy here, he's trying to help out Darth Vader. And down the bottom, you've got this little guy who's trying to run his own little scam as well. So guys, this is kind of what happens in the crypto space. And you just have to be careful with some of this stuff. And Poly Network have actually sent out this open letter to the hacker. So they have sent out a letter, and it says, "Dear hacker, we are the Poly Network team. We want to establish communication with you and urge you to return the hacked assets. The amount of money you hacked is the biggest one in the DeFi history. Law enforcement in any country will regard this as a major economic crime, and you will be pursued. It is very unwise for you to do any further transactions. The money you stole are from tens of thousands of crypto community members, hence the people. You should talk to us to work out a solution. Poly Network team." And so that message just went to the bandit, and the bandit, it's going to be interesting to see how this one plays out. So basically, the bandit, and this is all happening publicly and it's happening live, and you can see the value of some of the hacked or the exploited, you know, crypto on this website right here as it happens. And you know, how is this bandit going to get away with the funds? That is the next question. Is this person going to get away, or will they get prosecuted by the long arm of the law? And it says here, a couple of updates. Tether froze approximately $33 million in relation to the hack. And it also shows that the hacker tried to move assets, including USDT Tether, through the Ethereum address into the liquidity pool. Curve.fi records show the transaction was rejected. And it also shows that 100 million has been moved out of the Binance Smart Chain address in the past 30 minutes and deposited into the liquidity pool, Ellipsis Finance. So I guess, what is the takeaway of all this? So you always remember, you know, on the crypto journey with Crypto Zeus, things like this are kind of rare. So it is rare, but the takeaway takeaway is there are bad agents out there. These things can potentially happen. It does. It is very disappointing for all those people who had assets on that Polygon, on the Poly network. And, you know, but it's just a factor, you know, and it comes with the territory of cryptocurrencies. What does CryptoZeus do? You have to practice good cybersecurity. So you always have to make sure you're not running any viruses on your computer. You know, there isn't much exploits going on. You have to watch out for the social phishing campaigns. You have to watch out for fake comments as well. And overall, CryptoZeus, I also take a pathway of diversification. So I love my cryptocurrencies. I love them all. I want to see them succeed. But ultimately, you know, I do diversify into other types of financial assets, because one of the elements of that is, you know, through diversification, you know, if these things were to happen and a bandit was to come, they wouldn't get all your funds. So that is the practice. But guys, interesting story today. A little bit of spooky music in the background. I thought I'd mix it up, make it a bit entertaining. But guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. CryptoZeus signing out.